When a customer has a query or an issue with your products or services, they expect a quick solution. A smooth ticketing process flow improves both the customer's and the service desk agent's experience, and at the same time, helps you manage your resources effectively. What is a help desk ticketing process flow, and why do you need it? A help desk process flow defines all the steps involved in resolving a customer query. It must show every step from the moment a ticket is received and assigned to an agent until it is resolved and customer feedback is collected. The process flow documents how tickets are assigned and prioritized, when they escalate, how they're sorted into different categories, how tickets in different categories are resolved. Besides streamlining ticket management, the help desk process flow has an important role in defining the metrics and standards for the service desk. By analyzing the tickets handled and the resources employed in moving forward a request, you can identify the bottlenecks in the process and take steps to improve them. Here are 5 steps to define a clear help desk ticketing process flow. Number 1. Understand the scope of the service desk. You need to know what you want to offer and how you will achieve it. In order to define that, make sure to analyze the following elements. Where do requests come from? If you offer omni-channel support, your workflow should include all the available communication channels and the actions triggered after each touchpoint. How many requests per day do you receive? Analyzing your ticket volume is crucial to understand how many tickets are related to each category or area you're getting, and how it evolves with time and improvements. Which departments are involved in the resolution of issues? Define if only the IT department should be involved in the resolution process, or if you need to onboard other areas and where the touchpoints should be. What are your SLAs? Defining service level agreements beforehand is very helpful to build the ticketing process flow according to those expectations. 2. Create the process flow. Once you have clearly defined your help desk specifics, the next step is to actually create the process flow. The goal here is that the guidelines you outline serve as many queries as possible. When creating the process, consider the following. Clearly document all the steps. Your workflow must contemplate not only the ideal scenario where end users self-solve their issues, it has to take into consideration all the possible escalations. Build a flexible workflow. The ticketing process is a standardization, and as such, it must adapt to multiple scenarios. The service catalog categories differ from one another and require different actions. Your workflow has to cover these possibilities to be helpful. 3. Build a knowledge base to support the process flow. You can design the best process flow in the world, but if it isn't clear or people don't have easy access to it, it won't be useful. Leveraging your service desk's knowledge base allows you to share the information your agents need to solve any ticket in line with your service quality standards. You can also provide your end users with knowledge articles to solve simple issues on their own and avoid submitting a ticket. 4. Configure the service desk software. After the process flow is designed, it's time to configure your service desk accordingly. Essentially, what you need to do is set up the ticketing routing process. This will determine what help desk and what agents the tickets are assigned, and the escalation rules that will apply. The basic steps to configure it are as follows. Establish the ticket triage process. Configure how the tickets will be routed to the agents, how they will be prioritized, and all the other steps involved until a ticket is fully resolved. Automate ticket assignment. Decide your preferred rule to automatically assign tickets. You can do it based on agents' availability, workload, or let them pick the requests from a queue instead. Automate workflows. Have pre-built processes to automate tasks that involve multiple departments to ensure that nothing is missing while solving the request. 5. Analyze, iterate, and optimize. The process doesn't end here. It's practically impossible to get everything right the first time round. To reach peak efficiency, you'll also have to iterate frequently in the initial stages. The following practices will help you analyze your process and find areas for change or improvement. Run periodic reports in your instance to have a better understanding of your service desk performance over a period of time. You can automate these reports in the Integrate Service Desk and share them with your stakeholders. Compare, contrast, and analyze your data. This is the only way you will identify areas of improvement as well as those that are solid. Implement the changes you need to get to your goals. You can change your ticket routing, optimize your knowledge base articles, implement gamification within your help desk, or any actions that you think are necessary. Even when you reach a solid process flow for your service desk, it's important to monitor the metrics and make sure you're not falling behind. As your organization evolves and the scope of the service desk changes, your process flow will also need to evolve. Now that you know how to do it, follow this set of best practices to properly implement your help desk ticketing process. 1. Automation is your friend. To streamline support services, automation is paramount. It will reduce the workload for the service desk team and help you better manage your resources. Automation can simplify activities such as ticket routing and escalation and collecting feedback. 2. Incorporate gamification into your workflow. In IT, gamification rewards the agents for completing tasks or reaching certain goals. Gamification may not seem like a priority when you're initially setting up the workflow, but once you've configured a stable process flow and your team has settled into the groove, it can boost their productivity and improve customer experience. For example, you can create an in-game currency for your team, which they can unlock for every ticket they resolve, or create a leaderboard based on the number of tickets they resolve. 3. Iterate and improve continuously. As we've mentioned, continuous iterations are necessary to keep your help desk ticketing process flow in an optimal state. So make sure to include data analysis into your regular activities as a help desk manager to spot areas of improvement and ultimately adopt a proactive approach to IT support. Do you have insights on this topic you'd like to share? Please leave them in the comments below. And don't forget to like the video and subscribe to InfGate Academy for more insights into the world of service management.